I'm Dr. Paul Mitchell, professor and extension state specialist in the Department of Agricultural and Applied Economics at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. In this series of videos, I'm going to talk about how ARC and PLC work for farmers. These programs are administered by the U.S. Department of Agriculture's Farm Service Agency, and they are for commodity support programs. They support commodity farmers across the U.S. The three options farmers have are price loss coverage, county agriculture risk coverage, and individual agriculture risk coverage. PLC, price loss coverage, establishes a price floor for each crop based on the national marketing year average price. County ARC, or ARC-CO is another term it's used, establishes a revenue floor for each of these crops based on the county revenue. And the last one is ARC-IC, for ARC individual coverage. It establishes a revenue floor for all your program crops as a whole based on your farm yields and the national prices. We're going to go through all three of these programs and the options farmers are choosing, but before we get too far, I want to talk about the eligibility for the sign-up for ARC and PLC. If you own or operate a farm with base acres, generally you're eligible. That's who enrolls in these programs. A simple way to think of it is if you received an ARC or a PLC payment over the last few years, you're most likely eligible again. These base acres are always associated with the crop and have a payment yield for that crop as well. The common program crops here in the state of Wisconsin are corn and soybeans, as well as small grains like wheat, oats, and barley, and some people have sorghum base acres. These will also have payment yields with them. And so, for example, a farmer may own, operate an FSA farm. This is to be designated by the FSA with the farm serial number. That farm maybe says has 160 actual acres, and on those 160 acres, there might be 100 base acres of corn and 40 base acres of soybeans. Each of those, that corn will have a payment yield of, say, let's say 140 bushels per acre, and that soybeans will have a payment yield of, say, 40 bushels per acre. That's how these programs work. Eligible farms will choose which program to elect for their base acres on each of their FSA farms. In some cases, such as with share leases, they will decide with their landlord. Sign-up for these programs started on September 3rd of this year, 2019, and goes on until March 15th of 2020. At this point, farmers are first choosing their sign-up for the 2019 and the 2020 crop years, and that sign-up is going to be the same for both years. Crop years 2021 and following are going to be annual elections. Instead of doing 2 years in a row, it's going to be each year will be an annual sign-up with its own options to switch each year. Just to be clear, you cannot enroll new base acres in this farm bill, nor can you change the crop allocation between base acres. Neither of these have happened for a while. You can update your payment yields this year, though, and that is a strong recommendation. If you can update your payment yields with the increase, you should definitely do that this year. When you do the sign up for these crops or for these base acres, you can mix these programs. County ARC and PLC are interchangeable. For example, if you want, you can do PLC for your corn and ARC-CO for your soybeans, and then on a different farm, do a different election. The focus on the media and most of the outreach on these programs has been on ARC and PLC. And when they say ARC, they usually mean county ARC. ARC-IC hasn't been particularly popular, and so it's not on a lot of people's radars at this point. The last farm bill, most farmers signed up for ARC for the corn and soybeans, and small grains is roughly split. About two-thirds signed up for ARC and about one-third signed up for PLC. ARC-IC, like I said, had very little sign-up, and so we haven't heard a lot about it, and a lot of people haven't thought about it. So there's been very little coverage, and so part of what this video series will do is talk about ARC-IC as well.